Picking up where we left off, what is a histogram? A histogram is a graphical representation of pixels in either the entire image or a select portion of the image. The graph separates each pixel into bins based on their grayscale or pixel values, kind of like paint chips are sorted by shades of the same color. Anytime you modify or stretch the histogram, you can manipulate the brightness and contrast of the image. A wide histogram results in more contrast. A lookup table is essentially an algorithm or predetermined set of instructions that the software applies to the initial image histogram in order to present a very specific type of appearance on the radiograph. If you select PA chest, when you perform that view, the computer will assign the lookup table to make that image appear optimum once it receives the data from the actual radiograph produced. It determines the numbers assigned to the input pixel values that change them into the output pixel values. What this means is it changes the brightness and contrast to look optimum. Selecting the wrong body part or projection, as we saw last time, when you perform an exam will affect the outcome based on the assigned lookup table. If you process a lumbar spine under an AP abdomen, the image is going to look washed out and have lower contrast than desired. Why? Because the lookup table for an AP abdomen is designed to visualize more subtle differences in tissue density, like bowel versus kidneys. The AP abdomen lookup table is not designed for high contrast orthopedic imaging, like the L-spine lookup table. Just looking at the original image on the left, the raw data produced by the X-ray beam doesn't look as polished as the post-processed image on the right. The lookup table for a PA chest used here is designed to accentuate lung markings. This is where technologists can get a little lazy over the years and never manipulate the technical factors because the software does such a great job at processing the images to look amazing over time. Unless you look for very specific criteria in your X-rays, people tend to lose that skill. Just remember, with all the software in the world and all the processing tools enabled, they're just tools. The data you provide that system is the most important part of the technologist's job. Those tools simply enhance the images, but if you're putting garbage techniques in with garbage positioning, you're going to get garbage radiographs. You need to master your technical factors in order to produce an optimum X-ray beam in order for those tools to do their jobs at peak performance. Changes in technical factors for a patient who has COPD with higher KV versus someone with emphysema where lower KV is required. Even if you use AEC, it's an example of a small change you can make to provide the best data in the form of the exit beam to get the most out of all the bells and whistles of whatever equipment you're using. Let's talk a little more about dynamic range. This is the range of values over which a system can respond, also known as the grayscale range. This includes hardware like the monitor and the computer, and it also includes the software. Contrast resolution is the ability to distinguish between similar tissues. Going back to what I said on the last slide, the computer's ability to enhance the visualization in tissue differences is going to be so much more if you're providing it with optimum technique in the initial data set. When people say they're just going to window an image, they just mean they only want to see a window or a portion of the entire dynamic range. Just remember that there's two functions of windowing, the window level and the window width. Window level regulates the brightness of the image. Window width influences the image contrast with the number of shades of gray seen. All right, let's move on to initial gradation processing. Gradation is the gradual passing from one tint of gray to another. Some textbooks call this gradient processing. Just think of the paint chip example, and we've got some kind of grayish looking paint chips on the right here. You can see a natural gradation with the bottom being darkest, and as you go higher in each column, they get lighter and lighter. It's the same type of gradation you see when your radiograph is processed. When you look at a gradient curve of a radiograph, remember these things. Left to right changes in the curve equal brightness change. Top to bottom changes in the curve, or the steepness of the curve, indicate changes in contrast. All of these changes occur in the intensity domain, which alters the histogram. You'll cover more of this next semester, but for now you can skip pages 504 to 507 and begin reading about parameters of gradient processing. There's four parameters that determine the shape and the position of the curve in gradient processing. Gradient type is the overall shape. Gradient shift adjusts the overall brightness for the entire pixel range. Remember, brightness is controlled by left to right changes in the curve, so this parameter will do just that. Gradient angle adjusts the overall contrast. Again, contrast is influenced by the steepness of the curve. Slopes greater than 45 degrees have increased contrast or very black and white images. A steeper lookup table curve means that there's a shorter grayscale and higher contrast. Gradient center is the central point of the lookup table, and curves shift and rotate from that point. I'm going to briefly touch on data clipping this video. Data clipping is what happens when you manipulate the window width and or window level, or the brightness and contrast, beyond the dynamic range or bit depth limit of that system. When you adjust brightness and contrast at the technologist control panel before it's sent to the radiologist, you're essentially limiting the data you're sending to them for interpretation. Adjusting the control panel is only meant to QC your images. Never use this to try to make your image look more presentable before sending it to PACS. If you use it at all, just reset it to its original state before you send it over. Example, you perform a portable chess for central line insertion, and you have a little bit of difficulty seeing where the tip of that line is. If you adjust the brightness and contrast to visualize it, that just means your initial data captured allows for that adjustment to be able to be seen, which is good. If you send it over in the state it's in after you've manipulated it, you've removed data from that image. The radiologist is going to have much better software on their workstation and will be able to enhance the image way more than you can at your workstation. Sending the original data set is going to give them a much better ability to make changes to see what they need to with the entire captured data than if you present a fraction of the data because it supposedly looks better at your lower quality workstation. We'll dive into data clipping a little bit more in the next video.